All right, guys, so welcome back to another brand new video. I hope you guys are all doing well today. Of course, today I want to give you guys an update on what is happening with Bitcoin and of course the entire cryptocurrency market. So starting off with Bitcoin, you guys clearly see it's still holding at $26,000. So right now it's currently at 26,300, and we did in fact see actually earlier this morning we actually saw Bitcoin having a slight drop. So right now we are in fact in the 4 hour time frame. If you go to the 1 hour time frame, you guys clearly see for the past few hours we actually saw Bitcoin having a slight drop, right? Nothing too crazy though, but this is in fact a slight drop we are in fact seeing for Bitcoin. We know Bitcoin for the past few days was in fact consolidating pretty strong, right, at around 26,600, but it did in fact have a slight drop. But right now Bitcoin is in fact looks is looking like it will potentially go back up right now. Okay, well, not really, but we will see. Okay, I will obviously keep you guys updated on what's going to happen with Bitcoin. But yeah, it's still holding strong at $26,000. Ethereum right now is now below $1,600. Okay, so just below $1,600, still holding strong in my opinion. And you guys clearly see overall the market today is not moving. Okay, the global crypto market cap is still above 1 trillion, which is always amazing to see. And today, okay, the market is slightly down. Nothing too crazy though. Okay, only 0.05%. So for the past 24 hours we aren't really seeing much movements. Okay, everything is sort of steady right now. Not much, we're not seeing much momentum for Bitcoin and crypto right now, okay, as we are in fact speaking. But it's been like this for the past few days, I'm not gonna lie to you guys, right? So I am not surprised, and you guys should not be surprised. Now let's talk more about what is going to happen with Bitcoin short term. So where will we potentially see Bitcoin in the next few months? So there's a lot of people out there that are in fact saying, okay, Bitcoin's gonna pump, right? We're not gonna see Bitcoin go back down to its previous bottom, and I'm one of them. I am with them on that one, right? But there is in fact a fair few people that are in fact saying we're gonna see Bitcoin go to like below 20K. So meaning we're gonna see Bitcoin maybe potentially reach back down to like $19,000 to 18, to maybe even its previous bottom back down at $15,000 or lower. So that's exactly what I wanna talk about, right? So these upcoming few charts, starting off with this one, I really want to talk about where will we potentially see Bitcoin in the next few upcoming months, right? And of course before the halving, because we know the halving is in fact about to happen for Bitcoin. So let's talk about it. Okay, so right now you guys can see this chart is showing you guys the peak and the bottom. Okay, so we know Bitcoin recently, back last November, reached a bottom of around $15,000. Now a lot of people are in fact saying we're gonna see Bitcoin drop back down to its previous bottom, but understand guys, Bitcoin has never done that throughout Bitcoin history. Once Bitcoin reaches a specific price of a bottom, okay, and we see Bitcoin slowly recovering back up to the upside, right? That's what we have in fact been seeing for Bitcoin throughout 2023, right? It reached 15K, and then ever since then, throughout January to where we are now, we are in fact seeing Bitcoin slightly recovering back up to the upside, right? So I've told you guys as many times, we're not gonna see Bitcoin go back down to its previous bottom. That's for a fact. Okay. And I told you guys, we may not even see Bitcoin reach, below 20K or even at 20K. I think personally, it's just very unlikely to happen. It could happen, right? But what can cause Bitcoin at this point to drop that much, right? Understand, guys, the halving for Bitcoin is, in fact, about to happen. I don't think right now is the time for Bitcoin to drop even more, like having a massive crash back down to the downside. Like it could potentially happen, who knows? We might act, I've said this before, we might actually see Bitcoin having a massive one last drop before a massive pump up to the upside. Okay, but we will see, guys. But in my opinion, I think it's all ups from here. Now of course we might actually see some pullbacks for Bitcoin, who knows, right? But we will see. But in my opinion, I think it's all up from here. And you guys clearly see every single time we reach a bottom in a bear market, Bitcoin doesn't go back down to its previous bottom. Like who knows, it might, but we will see, guys. Okay, but I think that's just very unlikely to happen, right? For us to see Bitcoin go back down below, below 20K. Okay, personally, that's just me. I think that's very unlikely to happen. So I think the opposite. I think Bitcoin's going to be all up from here. And I told you guys many times, I really do see a 50k Bitcoin sometime maybe this year in 2023 or maybe next year, early next year of 2024. So this chart right here is showing you guys, okay, you know, that we might actually see Bitcoin reach 48,700 before the halving. So we know the fourth halving for Bitcoin is in fact about to happen. We are literally 7 months away. Okay, so potentially April next year in 2024, that is going to be our next halving for Bitcoin. Okay, and when the halving happens, guys, we're not going to see, you know, Bitcoin pump straight away. Okay, you got to give it a few months time, you know, you got to give it time, and then it will pump, right? And that's why I've always been mentioning, you know, maybe towards the end of the year in 2024, that's when we will really see Bitcoin start to pump, okay, and start, you know, the next bull run, entering the next bull market, bull cycle. So this chart is just showing you guys that, you know, before the halving, we might actually see Bitcoin reach at least 48,700, okay, close to 50k. And I told you guys this many times, you know, I really do believe towards maybe the end of this year in 2023, we might actually see Bitcoin reach at least 45k to even 50k. Okay, call me crazy, but I think that is very, very possible. And understand, October is next month. This month of September is about to end, and we are in fact about to enter the new month of October. We know October, Bitcoin does perform pretty, pretty well, and I will get into that towards the end of this video. But yes, 48,000 close to 50k is possible before the halving for Bitcoin. And this chart also shows you guys, okay, that yes, we're gonna see Bitcoin reach at least $48,000 maybe once the halving happens, right? So that's literally, you know, few months away, guys. Okay, so yeah, we're gonna see Bitcoin continue to pump up to the upside. It may seem boring right now where we are right now for Bitcoin all the way down here, but understand, guys, okay, I really do believe, okay, we're gonna see Bitcoin reach at least 50k maybe towards the end of this year in 2023 or early next year in 2024. And that's exactly what this chart is in fact showing. Okay, so it's very, very possible. Okay, it really, really is, guys. So be excited for that, for all my Bitcoin holders out there, because yes, a 50k Bitcoin before the halving is possible in my opinion. Okay, it really, really is. And that's just me. I could be wrong here, guys, but I think it's very, very possible. And I understand when Bitcoin reaches 50k, it's not going to be back up to its previous all-time highs. It's going to be close to its previous all-time highs. Okay, more than halfway there. So that's going to be really exciting, right? And that's when a lot of people, you know, they're going to get in, okay, they're going to potentially FOMO, and that's when a lot more excitement will start to happen in the market, right, especially for Bitcoin. So that's that. Now, let's talk about long-term now and where we are right now. So right now, we are pretty much in the pre-bull, okay? We know the bull market hasn't, you know, officially happened just yet. We are still, in my opinion, we're still in bear conditions, but we are in fact in the pre-bull, okay? And we have the first bull, which is going to be next year in 2024. And of course, the second bull is going to be 2025. And I told you guys many times, 2025, keep a lookout, because that's when everything's going to pump, okay? Bitcoin's going to skyrocket. Most likely your favorite altcoins are going to skyrocket as well, right? Alt season is obviously right around the corner, but altcoins right now are not looking too good, which is good, right? When it's not looking too good, that is when you want to take that as an opportunity to buy more, okay? And that's exactly where altcoins are right now, and of course Bitcoin, of course, right? So this chart just obviously shows you guys where we are currently right now and where Bitcoin will, you know, end up next year, you know, in 2024, and of course 2025 is going to continue to pump up to the upside, right? So 2024, the halving is going to happen, and of course 2025 is going to continue to pump as well. Okay, so yes, clearly see Bitcoin $200,000. I think yes, we will potentially see a 200k Bitcoin. Okay, I've been talking about this for many times now, and it seems like a lot of people out there are in fact agreeing that yes, we will potentially see, you know, Bitcoin reach at least 200k or maybe even over 200k by the year 2025. So sometime in 2025, I really do honestly see a 200k Bitcoin in that year. Okay, do I think 200K is the peak for Bitcoin? I don't know. Okay, I really don't know. Maybe we might actually see Bitcoin go further upwards than 200K. Okay, who knows, guys? But I know for a fact we will at least see a 200K Bitcoin in the next Bitcoin bull market. Call me crazy, but I think that is very, very possible. Okay, just my prediction. Okay, that's that. So the halving is really important, guys. Let's talk more about the halving. I know I talk a lot about the Bitcoin halving, but it's actually really, really important. So since we are literally a few months away from our next Bitcoin halving, I just want to show you guys that every single time we have the Bitcoin halving, the price pumps for Bitcoin. Okay, so let's look back at our previous halvings for Bitcoin. So 2012, the halving day was sitting at $12, literally in 2012. Bitcoin was sitting at $12. Okay, and then 1 year after, right, the halving, it reached over $1,000. Amazing, right? From $12 to $1,000. Think about that. Think about how much Bitcoin has pumped. Okay, so 2016, moving on, halving day, it was sitting at $648. And then 1 year after, it pumped all the way up to $2,500. $2,500, guys, think about that. Okay, that's absolutely amazing. And then our most previous halving, okay, was in 2020. So the halving day, Bitcoin was sitting at 8,570. Okay, then 1 year after, it pumped all the way up to $56,000, almost $57,000, right? So just think about that, guys. And this just shows you guys that every single time we have the Bitcoin halving, the price tends to pump, okay? And it will. So the year 2024 to, of course, 2025, we will really see Bitcoin pump, guys. Okay, and I really want all my Bitcoin holders out there that's watching this video right now to be really pumped for that. Okay, so Bitcoin right now is obviously a great buying opportunity. Right now, we're not seeing much momentum for Bitcoin. It's still below $30,000, which is a great buy, especially for long-term investments. And you should be investing into Bitcoin long-term because it's a great long-term investment to hold, right? Has store of value. We all know that for Bitcoin. So right now, I'm personally buying as much Bitcoin as I possibly can. Okay, and not just Bitcoin, but also Ethereum, right? If you guys haven't seen my most previous video, you should definitely check it out. But yeah, you guys already know this. You know, if you guys have in fact been watching my videos, you know, I've just personally been stacking Bitcoin and Ethereum. And of course, other altcoins, but my main investments are my big holdings. And the ones that I'm really focusing on is just Bitcoin and Ethereum. Very, very simple, right? Because I'm here for long term, guys. I'm not trying to, you know, make a quick buck. I'm trying to build generational wealth, right? So that's that. Now, to end off this video, I really want to, you know, give you guys an update on the Bitcoin monthly returns. So far this month, surprisingly, Bitcoin is still up in the greens, 1.95%, pretty much 2% for this month in September. And this month is in fact about to end in the next pretty much 5 days. So, you know, we could potentially, for the first time in 6 years, see Bitcoin end off this month in the greens. Because, you know, for the past 6 years straight, for the month of September, we actually saw Bitcoin not performing too great. So it will be amazing to see, I guess, for Bitcoin to end off this month in the greens. And of course, like I said earlier in this video, October is coming up. And we know October, Bitcoin does perform very, very well. And this is where I'm really excited, and you guys should be excited as well for the month of October for Bitcoin, because I really do believe next month we're going to see Bitcoin pump. That's just me. Okay, I'm going to say it here. Personally, I think in the month of October, we're going to see Bitcoin pump. Okay, so that's just me, right? So that's that. But guys, I'm going to go ahead and end this video here. I hope you guys all enjoyed it. Give a thumbs up, of course, and of course, subscribe to the channel if you guys have not yet already. I would always appreciate that. So on that, guys, I'm gonna go ahead and end this, and I catch you guys all in my next video. Have a good one, guys.